From 1997 to 2002, I served as an interpretive guide on Amtrak's Coast Starlight between Seattle and Portland. Led by Bill Lee and Warren Broderick, we Seattle-Portland guides created a script illuminating local history, scenery, and lore. Our tremulous voices conveyed the excitement of going, seeing, and possible revelation around the next bend. Service manager Brian Rosenwald sought to revive train travel in the Grand Manor and made the Coast Starlight Amtrak's finest, complete with first-class parlor car, movie theater, wine tasting, onboard entertainers, and interpretive guides the length of the route between Seattle and Los Angeles.
Late. 8 minutes. Still in the station. Coast Starlight. Another Portland trip. What will happen on this? Stay off. Don't sit. No looking. No stopping. No toilets. No sex. No fires and no camping. Well, I guess we've been warned.
Southbound to the Los Angeles. This is the main stack on alarm plan speaking. We'll be open 1:15. Selections I have today. Nice cold beer from Siberia. Super cold beer. Cocktail service, which is a mixing drink. Especially I have a mean Italy, Nasty Bloody Mary. White wine, white Zinfandel, also premium beer. Ham and Swiss cheese and a hoagie roll, cheeseburger, breast chicken sandwich made in USA, hot doggy, hot pocket pepperoni cheese pizza, chicken bean burritos, made in USA, Pepsi Cola, orange juice, cranberry juice, apple juice, mo juice, potato juice, you name it. At the moment you look at the right side through the window, lots of sky, lots of land, lots of tree. You look at the left side, lots of same old. You look at me, lots of drink, lots of food. My name is Steve Tung Chung. Ted Conglo. I forgot my name. Last name is Lee. I'm going with the final destination to Los Angeles. Open to serve. Come on down. Thank you, y'all. Y'all coming.
For the town of Kent, fast-growing suburb of Seattle. Way back in the 1880s, this town was also known locally hereabouts as. Well, the state of affairs persisted for 1 year, and finally the farmers and tradespeople down here in old Titusville got fed up. After all, they deeded over land for a railroad track, and with the assumption that they would have train service. So in September of 1885, they convened a town meeting here in Titusville, and they demanded the trains be put back at once, or they would take over the track and run their own trains. So the trains were put back, and they've been running happily ever since.
Point came when Warren Broderick's spoof conductor Craig Billings with a scuba diver waving the tentacle of a rubber octopus underneath the Tacoma Narrows Bridge. Centralia, the halfway point, founded by the son of slaves, a dark past, now a major antiques emporium.
Capital of Washington, and is the location of a very famous local landmark. Now on the right side of the train, keep your eyes peeled, one and all, for the world's largest egg. Here it is, right here, right now, the world's largest egg. It's made of plastic.
Waiting for it to hatch. Waiting years.
And now you know where rubber chickens come from.
What is this thing called American Beauty? What is this thing called American life? Vancouver, early outpost of manifest destiny. Welcome to the City of Roses, a pedestrian-friendly downtown with many good things to see and do. A calm, contented old town, Portland, with nothing to prove, unlike ceaselessly striving Seattle. Luncheon at Huber's or the Oyster Bar, then an afternoon of discovery, the muse's staring in cryptic amusement. Sun, sometimes on time, sometimes, well, what's the rush? Chief Umtux, Lewis and Clark, Hulda Klagger, George Washington Bush, the spirits smile. day's journey into night, bearing witness to America. A river flowing, a dog leaping, a tree growing, a child waving, a long train running.